During our July virtual UX conference, Jacob Nielsen held a Q&A session. In that session, Drew from Singapore asked, "What are the potential UX problems for virtual reality design, and how can we evaluate VR applications?"
Yeah, well, virtual reality is, it's a new media form, right? It's a new computer format. And so that gives its problems in its own right, in that users don't know how to use even the most basic operations. And I think that's a concern right there. In addition to the standard concerns about what features should we have, how do we support the application, but we even need to support people just being able to manipulate the user interface. And so this is very similar, actually, to how it was back in the 1980s when, you know, I did do early usability studies, and we had the first kind of commercially available graphical user interfaces with things like a mouse and all of that. And so at the time, Apple actually shipped the Macintosh with a little animation kind of introduction to how to use a mouse. But as you know, in any kind of computer training, some people get it out of the box, they get the training, and other people just get the computer without the training. And so people who would just walk up to a computer and see the mouse for the first time had no idea what to do. And actually, you know, so some of these studies were like, people would use like, oh, this is like a remote control, click, make something happen. Or other people would like turn it around. This was like back this mouse, which had like a rollerball, so it would use it like a trackball. And you also had these like a very tentative mouse movements. So that is what we saw back in the days. And you had to teach people how to use a mouse before you could even get into studying the other things. And in VR, you're going to have similar problems. And you're actually, in many ways, going to have worse problems, because manipulating a virtual reality has many more degrees of freedom or degrees of complexity than using a graphical user interface. Because typically, you know, things like scrolling, for example, right? You have two dimensions of scrolling. And actually, for websites, we even like to say, yeah, scrolling up, down. Yes, scrolling up, down. Scrolling left and right. That's not so good for websites typically. So websites are even simpler. But traditional applications, they do two dimensions of scrolling, right? But in VR, you have, first of all, you have your position in that world. That's three dimensions of where you are. And then you have your direction of viewing, which also has three dimensions of freedom. And so there's six dimensions total you've got to control. And so that's a vast additional complication. And then in addition to that, you have that there's no real conventions or standards for how things are represented or what you're going to do. And then, you know, we have our standard usability problems, which is the application, the tasks, actually doing something useful. And this is where I would really recommend significant user testing. I mean, I always recommend for anything, as you know, I always recommend you doing usability studies, but I think much more so when you're in a new technology where you have these problems with just basically operating it, which can trip up completely any otherwise good design. But then furthermore, there's that question of, is that application even useful at all? And I really advise, don't just like demo it, or just don't show to people, say, do you like it? Because yes, these are kind of cool right now for many people, but do they really add anything? Do they really do anything useful? And useful can be in many ways. I mean, useful could actually just be that it's fun and enjoyable, particularly if it's a game, but there could also be also more kind of enjoyment style applications, like touring a tourist site to think if you want to go there on a vacation, or touring a house that's for sale before you go out there, you know, and make your way physically there to see the house. A lot of those type of applications, campus tours for universities and so forth. But do they really add anything over just a set of a slideshow? And then you have real applications where you're actually doing something, and they're even more so. We've got to do this sort of standard usability testing of giving people tasks, actually do something real, discover something, find something, do something, accomplish something, and then see if people can do it. And then there's some tweaks in how you run that those studies compared to a normal study. For example, there was actually just some research done that's shown if you're going to do a survey to users, like, how much do you like this design, for example, on a 1 to 7 scale or something. it's better to do that as a simulated survey within the virtual reality than having people like take off their goggles and then have a sheet of paper and they mark, you know, 6, 5, 3, whatever, because that takes them out of the world and that's sort of distracting to be in, out. So even though it's also a little bit still, like you pop up in the world, here's like a survey, while you're like fighting dragons or something, but that's actually better to do. So there's some tweaks in how you may run to study, but honestly, the way to run usability studies with virtual reality is like run any other usability study, which is particularly, I mean, first of all, you get representative users and so on. And then, as I said, give them tasks. Don't just like play around with this. That can also be a task. See what you like. But also actually do something real and see if people can do it, because that's when you'll discover that your controls don't work or your conceptual model for the application completely doesn't match what people want to do.